some of our recent videos, we've been dealing with fractional exponents, with expressions that look like this. We defined x to the 1/2 as the number you square to get x. Now, some of you know there's another notation we use for that same idea. We write it like this. Call this the square root of x. We call this funny little symbol a radical. And this just means the number that you square to get x. Sounds an awful lot like the explanation we gave to this, and that's because these two are exactly the same thing. There's no difference between these two. So when you see the square root of x somewhere, you think x to the 1/2 power. Or you go the other way, you see x to the 1/2 power, you think the square root of x. So that takes care of raising things to the 1/2 power, writing them with this funny little symbol. Again, we call that a radical. But now, how are we going to write other fractional powers with radicals? Now, 27 to the 1/3, if we start off just by writing in a radical and putting 27 inside, well, we have a problem. That's the square root of 27. That's 27 to the 1/2. We want 27 to the 1/3. So the way we say that is we put a little 3 up here on the radical. Usually they write it even smaller than that, but I want you to be able to read it. We put a little 3 on the radical like that, and that says not square root, it says cube root, the number that you cube to get 27. In other words, it says 27 to the 1/3. So these two are the same. Now, of course, 27 is 3 cubed, so I can write this as cube root of 3 cubed, and, well, the number you cube to get 3 cubed is 3, so this is just 3. So that takes care of cube roots, things raised to the 1/3 power. Well, you know what we're going to do with this one down here. This is raised to the 1/5 power. To use a radical to write that, we start with our radical. Because we're dealing with the 1/5 power instead of a square root, we're going to put a 5 right there on the radical, and then we put the 100 inside. And that's all there is to it. Now, we can't simplify this any further. And here's why. If you see, 2 to the 5th is 32. We're looking for the number whose 5th power is 100 here. That's what this means. This is the 5th root. 2 to the 5th is 32. 3 to the 5th is 243. So the number we need to raise to the 5th power in order to get 100 is somewhere between 2 and 3. It's not a whole number. We can't even write it as a terminating decimal. You can't write it as a fraction, one integer divided by another. This is the best way you can write it. All right, so we've taken care of square roots, numbers raised to the 1/2, numbers raised to the 1/3, numbers raised to the 1/5. It looks like we can take care of something raised to 1 over any integer. What happens if our fraction has something other than 1 in the numerator? So we'll start with this. We'll say 3 to the 2/3. Well, we know how to deal with things raised to the 1/3 power, so I'm going to take out one of those handy exponent rules and rewrite this as something raised to the 1/3 power. 2/3 is just 2 times 1/3. So I can write this as 3 squared raised to the 1/3 power. That's just our power of a power exponent rule. And we know how to deal with things that are raised to the 1/3 power. We know how to write that with a radical. It's the cube root. And we put the 3 squared inside. So this is just the cube root of 9. And that's as simple as we can write it, and we're all set. Now, if we look back at this, there's nothing particularly special about this 3, this 2, or this 3. We should be able to do this anytime we have something raised to a fractional exponent. Let's take a look at that. Here we have any old number raised to any old fraction. We're going to say that m and n here are integers. We're going to write this with radicals, and we can follow the same steps that we just did. We can use our exponent rules. This is x to the m times 1 over n. So we use our power of a power rule next. This is the 1 over nth power of x to the m. And once again, we can write that with a radical, putting the n out here on top of the radical and the x to the m inside. So whenever you see something like this, a number raised to the fractional power, it's just the nth root of x to the m, and you can now go the other direction as well. You see the nth root of some power, you can write it with a fractional exponent just like this. These two are exactly the same thing.
Thank you.